this out, kids. It's so great to see you all again. Today we have another incredible Bible story to explore together, and I know God has some special things He wants to teach us. But before we now dive in, let's take a moment to connect with God in prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for bringing us here today so we can learn more about you. We are just so excited to hear your word and to discover the lessons you have in it for us. Please help us to focus and to understand and to take your word to heart. And Lord, as we sing and praise you with some songs, please fill our hearts with joy and remind us of your great love. In Jesus' name we pray this and we all say Amen. So all right, everyone. It's now time to get on our feet and sing and dance for Jesus. So let's not show God just how much we love Him by giving Him our very best. Are you guys ready? Awesome, let's go.
There's nothing my God can't do.
All right, everyone, before we now jump into our new story for today, let's first do a quick recap of what we learned last week with the story of the brave and beautiful queen. Do you guys still remember who it was about? Yes, our story was all about a lady named Esther, and it was now based on Esther chapter 2 to 5, Esther chapter 7, and Esther chapter 9, verse 20 to 22. Now, from our story, guys, we learned some really important lessons. First, we learned that we need to be careful who we take advice from, because when the king listened to Haman's advice, it almost cost him his own wife's life. We should rather let the Holy Spirit guide us when it now comes to big decisions. Now, we also learned about the importance of being brave when we do something for God. Because, you see, it was very risky what Esther had to do to save the Jews. But she didn't care. Esther was not willing to do what it takes to save God's people. And in the end, everything worked out. Now, just like Esther, we too need to be brave when we do things for God, even if it's risky, because guys, He will protect us. Now, lastly, we learned that God has a special plan for each and every one of us, and we don't need to be someone special for Him now to use us. You see, just like Esther, we too make mistakes, but that doesn't mean God doesn't have a plan for our lives. Now, guys, I hope you guys memorized last week's memory verse, because now we're going to say it together. Are you guys ready? Awesome. Who knows if perhaps you were made queen for just such a time as this. Esther 4, verse 14. Great job, everyone. You all did so well. Now, let's get ready to dive into today's new story and see what God wants to teach us. Today's story is called The Walls Go Up, and it is based on Nehemiah chapter 1 verse 4, chapter 6 verse 15 to 16, chapter 8 verse 1 to 3, chapter 10 verse 28 to 29, and lastly chapter 12 verse 27. Now guys, believe it or not, but today is actually our very last Bible story we're going to be doing from the Old Testament in our Bible in 1 year series. I actually can't believe we worked through the entire Old Testament so quickly. Now, are you guys ready to see what our last story is all about? Awesome. Let's watch it together.
Nehemiah was the cupbearer to King Artaxerxes of Persia. Nehemiah heard that Jerusalem was in ruins and that his friends there were in trouble. He asked God to help them. God gave Nehemiah the courage to speak to King Artaxerxes. Nehemiah asked if he could go to Jerusalem and help them fix their walls. Artaxerxes agreed. Nehemiah left for Jerusalem. Nehemiah walked around Jerusalem. Things were even worse than he'd heard. "This will be a big job," he told the people. "But with God's help, we can rebuild these walls." Everyone worked in families and groups, fixing the gates first. They fixed the sheep gate, the fish gate, the dung gate, and the other gates. Then they started rebuilding the walls. First, their enemies laughed. But as the walls grew higher, those enemies prepared to attack. So God's people worked with a tool in one hand and a sword in the other. After just 52 days, the wall was finished. Ezra the priest read God's law to the people. They promised to obey God's law and praised him for protecting them.
Are you guys now ready to see what we can learn from this incredible story? Well, let's dive in. The first thing that we can learn is God gives us courage. You see, Nehemiah was a Jew living in Persia, just like Esther from last week's story. Now, Jerusalem was the town of his people, the Jews, and its walls were destroyed by Jerusalem's enemies. Now, when Nehemiah heard this, he wanted to do something to fix it, but he had to ask permission from the king to leave in order to do that. Now, just like we learned last week, What doesn't just go up to the king and ask him for things, especially when it doesn't concern the king at all? I mean, the king was the ruler of Persia, and so why would he now allow his cupbearer to go and fix another city's walls? But guys, Nehemiah was determined and asked God for help, and God then gave Nehemiah the courage to speak to the king. So guys, next time when you need to do something or speak to someone and it's maybe a bit scary, ask God to help you and give you the courage to do it. Now, let's look at the second thing that we can learn from Nehemiah's story. God will help us do the impossible. You see, when Nehemiah got to Jerusalem, he saw that the walls of Jerusalem were in a worse condition than what he initially thought. But instead of turning away from the job and feeling helpless, he told the people that with God's help, they can rebuild the walls. Now, from this, we can learn that when we face big challenges that seem impossible, instead of giving up, we should turn to God for help. Because you see, no task is too big when we have God on our side. I mean, think about it. Nehemiah didn't have the skills of a builder. He was a cupbearer, but yet with God's help, he helped everyone rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Now, the next thing that we can learn from today's Bible story is teamwork is important. You see, Nehemiah didn't try to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem by himself. He knew it was a big job that required everyone's help. So he gathered all the people together and assigned them to work in families and groups, and each person had an important role to play, whether they were now fixing a gate or building a section of the wall. Now, because they were working together, they were now able to fix the wall in just 52 days. Now, guys, from this we can learn that teamwork is very important, and when we work together, we can accomplish so much more than what we can on our own. So guys, never be shy to ask for help when you need it. God actually created us to work together, and he placed people in our lives to help us accomplish what he has called us to do. Now, let's look at the last thing that we can learn from Nehemiah's story. Never give up. You see, rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem wasn't easy, and Nehemiah and the people building the walls faced a lot of challenges, like the enemies mocking them and planning to attack them. But instead of now giving up and running away, Nehemiah and the people kept their trust in God and carried on with what they had to do. And because they never gave up, they completed building the walls in just 52 days. So guys, let's learn from Nehemiah and the people who built the wall. Next time when we need to do something and it gets difficult or we are mocked for doing it, let's not just give up. Let's push through and ask God for help to do what we need to do, especially if it's something for God. Now guys, I want us now to look at our memory verse of this week. It's in Nehemiah 2 verse 20, and it says, "The God of heaven will help us succeed. We, his servants, will start rebuilding this wall." Guys, what an awesome verse to memorize this week. Let me now show you guys what the moves are to help us memorize it a bit easier. The God of heaven will help us succeed. We, his servants, will start rebuilding this wall. Nehemiah 2 verse 20. Awesome guys. I want us now to do it one more time. Are you guys ready? Okay, let's go. The God of heaven will help us succeed. We, his servants, will start rebuilding this wall. Nehemiah 2 verse 20. Well done guys. Please remember now to practice it this week so we can say it together in next week's lesson. And remember, you can find the moves in our take-home page, so there's no excuse not to practice it. Are you guys now excited to see what craft we will be making today? Well, let's not wait any longer and let me show you guys what we will be making. Guys, don't you just love doing a craft each week that goes with our Bible story? I know I do, and it's just such a fun way to remember our story. Now, guys, to download the craft so you can make one at home, you simply need to go to the description and click on the blue link that says, "Here's today's craft link." Now, who's ready to see the crafts that were done by you guys for last week's lesson? Awesome, let's see how they turned out. Wow, guys, you all did an amazing job on your crafts. I loved seeing all the different ways you guys made them look. Each one was just so creative and unique, and it's clear that you guys put in a lot of effort into them. You should all be very proud of your hard work. Now, unfortunately, guys, we are almost at the end of our lesson. I know, it went by so quickly, right? But before we now go, we're going to sing one more song together. Are you guys ready? Awesome, let's go.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise. the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Oh, oh.
That was just so much fun. Now, before we go, let's first close our eyes and pray. Thank you, Lord, for another amazing lesson. Please help us to remember everything that we learned from Nehemiah's story. Please give us the courage to do amazing things for you and help us to not quit when things get difficult. Please send people our way that will help us and encourage us to do what you called us to do. And Lord, as we now go our separate ways, please protect us and guide us. In Jesus' name we pray this. And we all say, Amen. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. Remember now to practice your memory verse and send me your craft once you're done with them. I'll see you guys next week. Bye, everyone.